landed. Nice and warm. Sorting all the gear out, just met everybody up here. And then we'll go for a walk. Nice little village. Nice blue skies. That's what we like. Oh, couldn't have asked for any better weather. Nice blue skies. What's that, Jeff?
Looks like a rabbit.
Looks like a decomposed bunny.
Not edible,
Steve.
Oh, they're slippers.
Lovely day. Great to be out. The river behind now, and just come onto this flat plain. It's like some sort of old works or something. Notice board up here, I'll go up here and read it. Could be a gravel dump or something, by the looks of it. We'll see. There you go, back down by the river again. See that? Nice clear water. Lovely and warm out today. It is when you're walking. 20k on your back. But if you look right at the top, somewhere about here, you can still see a layer of snow. It was snowing early in the week, but I thought it'd have all gone by now, but obviously not. Still little bits laying around. But spring is definitely on its way today. And there's the lads over there. Photos, videos, God knows. The ruins of one of the old lead mines. Bits of buildings scattered everywhere. Going to stop for a quick brew. Well, right way stove. Gas attachment, and but one of the aerosols this time. A little bit lighter, quicker to use. Quick cup of coffee, and one of these cereal cookie and cream flavoured cereal bars out on the wrap packs. Don't look very nice, but it tastes alright. It's the main thing. That's where we've just come up. Quite steep. Water's running most of the way down it. Makes it a bit slippery. And we just come across this pile. I presume what you do is you pick up a stone, that one, and you add it to the pile. So we've been here. If you just make out ruins up there on top of that, and if you pan round, some more ruins. A couple of lads are already over there. Loads of different bits and bobs around here. Alright, I'm at the back, so I suppose I better catch up. These are the ruins from behind. Just come up and saw like splintered different sections. I don't know why. Should read up and find out. It's all little units, probably 6 foot wide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It's over a dozen. All split up into little sections. And across there you've got another ruin. Looks like an old house, doesn't it? Probably a foreman's cottage or something like that. I don't know. And round up to this one. I don't see any way up here. I can't believe how warm it is. It's only 25th March. And it's pretty boring. Doesn't help, but you've got a great big pack on your back, I suppose. I would say, up in summer, here, with the pack, you'd be struggling. You'd want something really lightweight. All little tunnels all over the place. You can see one over here. You can have a look at it. Seems to be water flooding out of it anyway, so. See the water, crystal clear. You can see on your way up. Don't quite know where it goes. Way up in the hills. Nice clear day. Well, guess what Tom's found? There it is. Look out the window. And you got snow. So Tom's playing snowballs. A bit of a breeze now. It's pretty high up. Like you've seen, there's still snow. See that ruin across the other side still? I would say it's probably been a foreman's cottage or something like that, overlooking the site. Don't know. Answers on a postcard. There we go. We can't forget a guest appearance by the dog. Hello. There's all the bags that we've all brought up with us, all the rucksacks. About one. You can see. Looking along them. There's a fair weight there. All except one. And that's Dave. And he's gone up there somewhere. He's gone to source the camp spot. So I think some of the lads are camping over there. Waterfall there. Some of them are camping there. And I'm going to camp just here, I think. Out the way of everybody. And there's Jay.
Not much fun, are
they? No. There you go, and that's me set up. Found a little spot by myself. I think there's some lads going to go there. And the rest of the lads down there in the ruins. I thought this was quite a nice spot, right in front of the waterfall. I'll give it a blast. Maybe a bit noisy tonight, but hey ho. I'm sure I'll be too knackered to worry about the noise and I'll just nod off. There you can see, right down the valley. Still snow up on the top, like I said before. You will have seen the tent before. Last time I had it out was in Bushcraft Forest. It's the Wildcamp Berris 1. Coffin shaped. Big enough for me. Nice and lightweight. I think the whole pack itself weighs 1.7 kilograms. So it's not too bad. And if that'll stay there, then you can see in there. It's fine. Left side, both sides. Obviously your out sheet is more of a shelter and the inside's just mesh. Half on the top. Not bad little tent. There's not much left of this building. See the walls come down. But in here, there's these three pipes. One, two, three. I think they're the old air pipes. Obviously, when there was mining, you had to get air down to them. So I presume that's what they are. And that looks like an old gable end of this building that I'm stood in. And there's more around the other side. I'm going to have a look. And that's the other side of the building. Still pretty well intact, say how old it is. And on here, somewhere, there's a little scripture, tells you all about it. Blakenthwaite Smelt Mill. There you go, put it in pretty close so you can all see it. And that's what it's all about. So there's little walls dotted all over the place. Good piece of timber up there for the door header. It's a few year old now. So now I've just climbed up a bit. Looking down into the valley where we are. You see my tent there on the right. On the left is that building where there's one, two tents in there at the minute. And then the rest of the lads are sat down here and I think they're going to camp somewhere just down here somewhere, I think. Another empty building here. And you've got the valley, just leads up that way as well. Around here, it looks like an old baking oven. Well, obviously not baking, but baking for something. An old furnace, should I call it? Seems to be in a bit of a strange place, but there you go. Half cylinder, cut out just here, and you see inside the remains, probably smelting in here, or something like that, not quite sure. And you see it goes right back into the bedrock. May have been smelting or not quite sure. say there was no tools used. It's a remarkable bit of engineering. Very clever. I just wrote down there on that plaque earlier on. It's I think it's 1821. So it's been here for a fair while, and it's stood up against decent weather. If it rains, if, I might be tempted just to come up here and sit in here tonight. We'll see. I've just walked a little bit further up, up from the camp, upriver, about a quarter of a mile, half a mile. There's a huge waterfall up here, and a strange looking building. You can see it in the picture, it's quite a weird shape. Don't know what that's all about, like. Looks like it's been an old mill house or something. Then up there there's another little ruin. It seems to be quite flat here. There's this the loading area or something. Not quite sure. I've just climbed out the valley. Absolutely stupid. Around the top, look like little lake tracks. Don't know what for, that's about the fourth one I've seen. Well, finally got back down onto the track. Slight difficult descent. That's where I just come down. I walked right across the edge, right to the end, looked down on the camp. Couldn't see a way down. Walked over to the other side, there's another stream coming in. Thought it might be a shallow bank. Try and get down that. No joy. So I've just come back over the top. Thought this looked the shallowest fall. So I'll try it. And now I'm back down on the track. Back to camp. Something to eat. I'm starving. Well, that's me set up for the night. Not night time yet, but just had something to eat. Just put a sleeping bag out ready. Under the sleeping bag, reflective sponge. Another blanket there as well, I'll put down a bit later on. So yeah, just gonna cheer out. Just gonna sit and chill now. Bought some, because I knew we was going to be walking, bought some waterproofs the other day. Good job really, I haven't used them. It makes the trip more pleasant. So yeah, everything I need in there now, overnight, when it gets a bit darker. Oh, it's a lovely day again. Just grew up. A bit cold overnight. Body was warm, my feet got a bit cold. Luckily I've got a little woolen blanket just wrapped right around my feet. Soon warmed up. Woke up and it's another lovely day. Everybody's just about packed away now. Just waiting for a couple of others. And then we'll set off back up the road. I think I picked a prime spot where I camped. The sun's just caught it this morning. There's our lads, and that's the road, well, the route we're going to take out this time. Came in on the left hand side of the picture, and we're going to go out on the right hand side. Up on the top, we've just done that climb up. Quite a steep climb, not too bad. Actually, we're just ambling up now as we speak. If that's everybody. And they came from between the trees. Yeah. That's where we've just come down. Now back up into the village. Bags off.